Welcome to the presentation of the case study about the FAO Progressive Management Pathway for Antimicrobial Resistance. This case study was undertaken as part of the COEVAL AMR project. And please allow me to first introduce myself. My name is Liz Alban. I'm a vet and I have a PhD in veterinary epidemiology from the University of Copenhagen. I'm a diplomat in the European College of Veterinary Public Health, and I'm affiliated with the Danish Agriculture and Food Council as a chief scientist. And besides that, I'm an adjunct professor at the University of Copenhagen. And my dual affiliation makes it possible for me to act like a bridge between the livestock industry and academia. Our case study and the video here, that relates to the Section 5 of the COEVAL AMR guidance website. And in our case study, we used selected parts of DANMAP. And DANMAP, that is the Danish Integrated Antimicrobial Resistance Monitoring and Research Program. More specifically, we looked at the parts of DANMAP that relate to antimicrobial resistance in Salmonella in pigs and pork in Denmark. And the objective of our case was to evaluate the tool, not to evaluate DANMAP. If you're interested in knowing more about DANMAP, please see the link you can see here on the slide. The FAO PMP AMR tool is designed by FAO. It provides guidance to countries for implementation of their national action plans for antimicrobial use and resistance. It is a stepwise approach, and it provides a self-assessment to measure the level of implementation. There are four focus areas: awareness, evidence, governance, and practices. And for each of these, specific activities, achievements, and key performance indicators are listed. And there's a dashboard showing progress towards optimal and sustainable antimicrobial use. The key findings were that the overall appearance worked well for country-level assessment, and it allowed generation of actionable outputs which could be subsequently discussed among stakeholders. The tool has an appealing progressive approach, and it covers the most important topics without going into too much detail. And finally, it spots actions to be taken. Our reflections regarding the tool is that it is user-friendly and, in general, meeting evaluation needs. We, to our surprise, we saw that residues of antimicrobials is part of the tool. And in Denmark, residue surveillance is in place, but it is not a part of DANMAP. But if you think about it, it does make sense to see residues as an indicator of the level of AMU stewardship. The tool requires less of the evaluator compared to the other tools we have investigated, but it warrants participation of multiple stakeholders. The tool is easy to complete and it made sense, at least from a veterinary point of view, but it is irrelevant to use for regional or small-scale action plans, and it is not meant for comparison between countries. The take-home messages are: first, FAO PMP AMR tool gives guidance to countries for implementation of their national action plans for antimicrobial use and resistance. It is a self-assessment tool with focus on awareness, evidence, governance, and practices. It is appealing in its progressive nature, and it is easy to use, although some training is needed, but it requires participation of several stakeholders. If you're interested in knowing more about the case, then you can see our paper, which was recently published in the journal Clinical Microbiology and Infection. And if you're interested in knowing more about FAO's tool, you can look at FAO's website. And before ending this presentation, I would like to acknowledge all my co-authors and you who are watching the video for your interest, and feel free to contact me if you have more questions about our case. Thank you and goodbye.